Is that the devil?
Are you ready, Baffy? A lot of people, when they come in my room or whenever I'm on FaceTime, certain people, black people, certain people are frightened. I'm talking about, like, they just caught trauma. Like, some people are terrified, don't even want to come in my room. I remember the RA, you know, how they did the inspections and stuff. She didn't even want to really, like, go through my room because of what was on my wall. She was like, oh, okay. Some people will say that this symbol is a satanic or demonic symbol, and we'll go so far to saying that people who have this symbol hanging in their on their walls, the statues, the necklaces, the Luciferian bracelets, all this other type of stuff, they would tell you that people who interact with these symbols and represent themselves with these symbols are of the devil. They're working for the devil, you know, and they'll tell you that these type of symbols are evil. You know, anything that Christians or religious people do not understand and are scared of, they will automatically label it as evil. This is the deity of fertility, deity concerning nature, and this is the representation of the perfected black man.
The Baphomet is none other than a symbol of the completed man, the black head, the Negro head. They venerated the goat god Pan, which was the Saturn, the black planet, to commemorate the black head of their black teachers. And so the symbol of the Baphomet, which was called the Baphomet, was a symbol of the Moors, because they said that they were the perfected man. Later on in the 1950s, it's venerated again with Gerald Gardner, who is the father of modern witchcraft. They worshiped the Sabbatic goat, the black man, which is also called the green man. Osiris is a black man. He is also the green man. The green man is the god of nature. That's where the horns on the head comes from. The horns of the head of Hathor, the cow goddess. Later on, not only did she become the evil golden calf in Hebrew, the cow goddess, the horns off of her head became horns of the devil. The Baphomet, Jesus, and all that, all that's the same thing.
Essentially, when you're dealing with the general analysis of Jesus, he's the archetype of Baphomet. Same thing with Muhammad, and the same thing with most heroic or messianic beings. When you're dealing with Lucifer as well, or Prometheus, they all share something with Baphomet. As a matter of fact, Baphomet, Lucifer, and Jesus are essentially the same person. So when you're dealing with Baphomet, you're dealing with the perfected black one. You're also dealing with Lucifer, the light barrier. So when you tap into the energy of Baphomet, you tap into the deeper aspects of nature, you tap into the deeper aspects of your inner self.